With voice control in iOS 13, you can use dictation to enter and edit text with your voice, which is useful if you have limited mobility. Here's how to use dictation, edit text, and use dictation, commands, and gestures together. Before you start, install iOS 13 or later on your device, and make sure voice control is turned on by going to your accessibility settings or by asking Siri. If this is your first time using it, check out the links in the description below to learn how to get started and use basic navigation. We're going to start by sending a quick message, but these commands will work in any app you can type in. When voice control is active and listening, you'll see a blue microphone in the top left corner of your screen. To enter new text with dictation, make sure you're in an active text box and then start speaking. By the way, comma, cake or flan, period. Don't forget to include punctuation as well. Oops, need to delete something? Delete previous character. This command will delete the last character you entered. You can also delete your last dictation by saying undo that. Let's try again, question mark. To edit something at the very beginning of a text field or document, you can move the cursor. Move to beginning. Oh, ellipses. That's better. Tap send. Voice control allows you to edit existing text and make even more corrections. Let's add a new item to this note. Main activity, colon, party clown. You can easily replace a word or phrase if you change your mind. Replace party clown with giant piñata. Need to make another correction? Voice control understands commands like move up two lines. Select previous word. Capitalize that. For a list of helpful commands, just say, show me what to say. These suggestions will change depending on the app you're using. Say, tap done to go back. If you want to correct a word, you can ask to see a list of suggestions. Select confetti. Correct that. These suggestions could be to correct spelling, show similar words, or even show relevant emoji. Say a number to make a correction. 4. If you want to stop voice control from listening for dictation, like if you're in a noisy environment, say command mode. This will pause dictation, but will stay active for navigation commands. To turn dictation back on, say dictation mode. Voice control can tell the difference between general dictation and commands, like to open an app or tap a button. Open messages. Tap iMessage. Happy birthday, exclamation point. Looking forward to seeing you Friday night. Cake emoji. Long press send. Tap screen. Swipe left. Swipe left. Tap send with balloons. And there you have it, a hands-free way to type and edit. For more about Apple's accessibility features, subscribe to the Apple Support Channel or click another video to keep learning.